ちょっと、あれですね、こう、皆さんの顔を今、じっくりとこう見てるわけです。
先生 is just looking at everybody, looking at your faces.
この人にはどう教えようかね。
How should I teach this person, that person?
この人にはどう教えようか。
How should I teach all the various people?
考えてないです。
He never thinks about this.
ほら、今年はですね、国宝術がテーマです。
The theme for this year is 国宝術。
国宝術っていう言葉はですね、芸術的な言葉とマナー的な言葉と2つに解釈してください。
The word 国宝術 should be interpreted in both an artistic sense, and in a sense of manners, ethics.
それ始めますか?
Shall we just go for it straight away?
Okay. その前に構えから始めましょう。
Okay, let's start with the 構え first.
構え5つあります。
There are 5 構え。
国宝術のあれ、俺教えたかしら、5つの構え。
Did sensei ever teach you the 5 構え of 国宝術?
Okay. Ready? Okay. Pedro? One more. Bring. 5人ね。
5 people.
おのおの構えやってください。5つの構えになるんです、小峠の。
There are 5 構え、小峠。
で、構えるとき言ってください。
Give the names of the 構え as you do them, please.
右下側の構え。
で、チモニの構え。
方向。
ボビー。
OK、みんな違ってても本当でもどっちでもいいですから。
It doesn't matter if they get it wrong or not. It really doesn't matter.
こういう感覚を養ってください。
You should try and learn this feeling.
実戦の時にはですね、構えっていうのは遅いんですよ。
Because in a real fight, 構えは too slow.
ね、構えの先に動くものです。実戦の時には構えが後でできるものです。
In a real fight, the 構え is something that occurs afterwards. You move before it.、
それで、ここにいる講談社の先生方は私の言われたことを知っていますから。
And that's why the high grades who are up here demonstrating, they understand what sensei is trying to put across.
構えは後で、皆さん知ってます。この中のインストラクターの先生がたくさんおります。
There are many instructors here, and everybody knows the 構え。
国宝術の5つの構えですね。右線眼、左線眼、ね、一文字の構え、方向の構え。ね、それから防備の構え、この5つですね。
右正眼、左正眼、平、防備、and, 方向、
皆さんも私を見習ってください。
So everybody, please learn from sensei.
盲録師でもこうやって覚えてるんです。
Even if you see none, you can still sort of remember them.
OK、ね。70歳だとね、大体こういう構えなのを忘れるそうです、一般的に。
Apparently, when you reach the age of 70, it is quite common to forget things like this.
はい、じゃあ一つの第一歩目の技からいきましょう。そして、徐々にですね、国宝術は何かということですね、形や技や技術や、そんなところからはみ出たものであり、はみ出ていないものです。それを実感していってください。
Ne? So now we'll start with the first technique of Koppo Jutsu, but you've got to remember, you've got to learn and taste that it's something that goes beyond forms or techniques or anything fixed.
ですから、Koppo だけの体質じゃなくてですね、今回はですね、忍者刀とそれから鉄板投げですか、鉄板術ですか、その3つでもってですね、コミュニティを取ったり、バランスを取ったりして、稽古していきましょう。
So we'll try and train here, not just doing the taijutsu of Koppo Jutsu, but also using the ninja to, the sword, and teppan nage, which means throwing iron plates, in other words, shuriken.
Okay, 10代の方は前に出てください。
Okay. Everybody graded 10th down and above, please come to the front.
Alright. こんなに今武神館で10代の方がいらっしゃいます。
As you can see, there are this many tenth dans in the Bujin Kan.
皆さん完璧な方です。
They're all perfect practitioners.
稽古しながらですね、よく僕にだけ教わるんじゃなくて、ここにいる10段の方の方が教え方は僕よりずっと前ですから。
So while you're training, don't just learn from sensei. Many of the tenth dans here teach far better than sensei can.
親切ですから。
They're very kind in the way that they teach you.
もう僕は年で親切になる暇がありませんので。
Sensei is too old to have time for being kind to people.
Okay. よくね、顔を覚えておいてください。
So look at them, remember their faces.
それで教えていただいてください。
And ask them to teach you.
それからね、モテ、俺英語使ったんだよな。 去年俺買って大学生来た時にね、 イスラエルの建国から何があったんで、あげるって言ってたので、送ろうとしたんだけど、送れないんで、今日帰って。
Sensei painted a special picture for Moti because last year was an important year for the nation of Israel, and wanted to send it to him, but he thought it would be better to actually present it in person here. The sort of poem there says is that many people think that when they do a technique, it's their own strength that is doing it. They don't realize that it's just the gods are working through them. And you should try and reach this level yourselves. Sensei tried to make this look as much like Moti as possible.
Thank you. Okay, the first technique. Sven Eriksson, you have to do it. So if he moves away, you can cut over the eyes. So don't hit this way. Yeah? And he starts by holding like so. And from this position, you hit that way. Yeah? Then you kick. And then, yeah? So what's important here is how you strike. You see he hold here. So you can't strike that way. So you strike this way. Yeah? And then, okay? To make this a little bit better is to move here. See? Keeping the distance. Because if we move here, he can pull in. Yeah? So move there. Now he's in front, he moves this. So now, and then you reach him better. Okay?
Sensei was just allowing people to do some sort of preparatory exercises to warm up. You should be able to understand this without Sensei actually telling you so.
Okay.
The important thing is that you move before the opponent actually grabs you. It's when they are trying to grab you. It's at that moment that you strike to their yugasumi. And then do this strike. This is how you move when they're trying to grab you. It's before they actually get you, you control them using your elbows. And then insert the strike. And then you go here.
Okay.
And then you're free to kick wherever you like. It's not fixed where you kick.
Okay.
So learn this koppo. It's the art of it rather than the technique. You understand? This is the important thing. There's no room for him to come in on you.
Okay.
And then you can kick wherever you like.
Understand?
So study this koppo, the art of it.
Okay.
And then the second punch. You move in like this. If he's doing two punches, you move in to this place. And then you can straight away move on to the next step.
Okay.
If you're doing the koppo right, then the techniques just emerge naturally. So it's the same whether he's trying to grab you or if he's trying to punch you.
No.
Okay. try and throw sensei if you want. It's the same. He can't, because sensei's knee is working.
Okay. Hey, okay. Last one again. Oh. I feel it.
You manipulate them freely.
Hey, last one. Hey.
He broke his arm when he was falling down here, right? You've got to be free. This is a kamae already. He's moving in a kamae. This is ukemi practice for Pedro. Then we can do a wide variety.
Okay.
So learn this. You can do whatever you like.
Okay.
There's some space.
Okay, me. I'll ask him.
One, two. One, two.
With your legs, you move here. Watch the legs.
Okay.
You cut from Kasumi backwards. And if he doesn't fall down, then you hit as well.
Okay.
So on the second punch, this is the important thing. If you're not on your guard all the time, you're going to be in trouble. The important thing is to find people who are not on their guard. And that's when you would throw a shuriken. So it's very important to go here. The weapons become alive. Everybody just try and get the first two steps right.
Hi.
You're moving out the way. And then you're straight away, you're able to hit them. If you're above, you can have two different strikes.
Okay. He can't escape because
Sensei is not taking him firmly.
Stick. Feel.
What does it feel like, Mako?
Muerto.
Dead. I have broken his leg now.
Understand.
You mustn't have the kind of techniques that people can see. You should study the koppo of it, the art, the knack. If it's a kind of technique that is visible, then you might get arrested. So what Sensei is trying to teach here is the art of Rembrandt. You know Rembrandt, the famous painter, right, from this area? Sensei is sure you all know him and his paintings and how he used light and shade. It's the same in Koppojutsu. So if you've got a free moment, just go to an art gallery and look at some of Rembrandt's pictures. Okay. Okay, we'll do it slowly now.
Okay, slowly.
You see? You understand? You hold it here.
Okay.
It looks a bit like conjuring.
Okay, I put it.
Next, the kamae.
Okay. Hōkō.
Change to hōkō.
Okay. Kamae.
You're in a kamae.
Okay,
let's go back to the original technique. The basic form.
Okay.
So the problem is, what do you do at the end of it? Don't let him grab hold of you. Like a woman, you might do it that way.
Okay.
Don't let him grab your breast. Then move. Move into hōkō no kamae, because it's quite natural to move there. It's important to strike in there. It's there is a kamae, but it looks as though there's none. So study this movement. So why are you guarding like this? It's because you can also take weapons. Take weapons out from inside. There might be many weapons concealed around here that you can reach if you do this position. So learn this sort of language, this communication. So he comes to grab. If he grabs you, learn to sort of bring these into your body and then move your legs. It doesn't matter how strong he's grabbing you. So if he thinks you're striking this side, you then strike the opposite side. And that's why it works. So learn just sort of physical principles like this too. Quite often you won't be able to do it that well. But you will if you move on the other side. And then you strike from underneath. Study this. So now you see the way of striking in Kokpojutsu changes again. Everyone sort of punches like this, yeah? And do the next punch. But if you use your legs, then he's no longer able to sort of evade by using hoko. He avoids doing seigan for the first. And if he goes into hoko for the second step, you can take him. Don't take his hand, take it with your legs. And don't go in that direction. Watch the direction the sensei's feet are moving. You take him in the space, in air. So if you move like this, then maybe you understand the sense of the kick at the end, kicking upwards. It's a kick that it actually says you strike upwards as though you're punching upwards with your leg. So we'll be able to do this naturally now.
Yeah.
Can you keep off the mat, please? One against one. You can do two if you prefer. Yeah, the technique, but with the kick at the end. Show that the kick is a strike going upwards, it's not a kick going in.
Okay. Alright. Okay.
So you can kick in many different ways. But it's got to be a kind of kick that is kicking upwards, that's striking upwards. Now, Arno did it fine. And the last move where you strike on the last move, rather than sticking your hand out, use your legs, use your knees. It's as though you're lifting up the opponent. Don't do it just with your arm. Think you might have shiko on your hands, the claws. Or a knife? Anything like that? On the last strike? You place it there and then you can cut afterwards. Place it first. So don't try and actually knock them down with this strike, but just use your knees to put your hand, to place your hand on their chin. So in that case it doesn't matter if they're really strong. So you should learn that this kind of thing does happen in a real fight. It's not just a question of trying to do this.
Okay. Hey, play.
So the reason for saying you go with your knees. You're going with your knees because it's as though you're supporting the opponent, you're helping them. You're not trying to knock them over. And then you're free to do whatever else you like. And you can go down. If you walk forward, you can go into the throat.
ですからね、技が一つ一つ変えてあるけども、力を入れたり入れなかったり、こう触ったり、あるいはパーンってやったり、あるいは パーンと当てて調子を見て引いたり、いろいろなものがそこで変化されるわけですね。
So you have the written descriptions of the techniques, but depending on whether you put in force or you don't put in force, if you just rest your hand there, if you grab their face and pull, it changes totally.
だから先輩一つ一つやるということは、結局隙が大きくなるということね。精一杯やることはね。
And so if you do every step too enthusiastically, it just means that you're going to have more openings.
でも歩くのも大股でいくと転んだりする。
It's like if you walk with big steps, it's easier for you to trip up and fall over.
転んで歩くと割とその転ぶ確率が少ないし、いろんなところで動けるということね。
If you walk like an ordinary person, then it's you're much less likely to actually fall over, and you can move in many different directions.If you look at the tango, the way that people walk in a tango and so on. You've got to learn to adapt the way you walk to the place you are. If many things are sort of around you and so on, there's quite a high probability you might bang into some of them if you're walking with two big steps. So learn the koppo, the art of walking too.
はい、じゃあ少しやってください。はい、全体感でやってください。今まで手とか足とかいろんなのやってましたけどね。全体感で今日やったやつを復習してください。
And now, up till now, you've already been thinking about where should my hands be, where should my legs be, and so on. But try for a few minutes doing it with thinking of your whole body.
それからね、実践の時は二人は正しくこう向き合いませんよ。
And also in a real fight, you don't have two people sort of standing opposite each other and sort of saying, yes, hello, you know, we're about to fight. It doesn't happen that way.
I don't understand.
It's okay.
実際の場合はお互いにまっすぐ、はい、構えてというように向き合わない。
In a real fight, you're not sort of facing the opponent and you take up your kamae and so on. It doesn't work.
実際の場合も、ね、悪いやつは横から来るからね。
Yeah, if it's a bad person, he probably comes to you from the side or from behind.
前から来るんじゃなくて悪いやつは後ろとか脇から来るからね。
Yeah, most bad people will try and attack you from behind or from the side.
そのために国宝術はこういう動きがね。
That's why you've got movements like this in Koppo Jutsu.
全体見える
よう
なね。
So you can see everything, you can feel everything.
じゃあ次の技に行きましょうね。
Okay, let's go to the next technique.
Alright. 次の技はお願いします。どうぞ。はい。
はい、パコ。攻略。Try to throw. Okay. Up. Sit back. The body, yeah? Sit back. Up. Sit back. Okay? Go.
投げ方はですね、柔道やった方いますか？
Is there anybody here who's done a lot of judo? Quite a few. So I'm sure that everybody knows there are many different ways you can throw people. So first, remember that your hips and your legs are connected.
まず足の動き方によってその投げから避ける方法を勉強しましょうね。
So let's study how to avoid a throw just by using your legs.
はい、相手がこれで飛んでいますよね。
With this, you'd be thrown.
ね、OK、こういうふうに。OK、こういったね。足で持ってます。
Use your legs.
見えることを覚えてください。
To avoid the throw.
こんなことやりますけど、そんな必要ありません。
In the forms, you do it like this, but there's no need to do that.
相手を崩すことを覚えましょう。投げようとする。
Learn to destroy the balance of the person trying to throw you, rather than trying to sort of avoid the throw.
All right. 投げに対してね。自分で踊ってみてくださいまずね。
Try dancing when somebody tries to throw you.
タンゴでもいいし。
It could be a tango.
ブルースでもいいし。
Dance the blues.
はい、これ。ですから、投げ技に対して、あれですね、まず避けるには足、それから肘。
If you want to avoid a throwing technique, learn to use your legs and your elbows. Just with this, everything changes.
Okay.
Learn to use your elbows well.
Okay.
Go ahead, throw me. You see the elbow? His leg's about to be broken.
Okay.
Use both. Nothing is fixed. This is important. If you can't make it with your legs, use your elbows. You can punch him.
Okay.
This kind of flow is important. Don't just think of the end of your hands. The throwing techniques? Learn to push them the other way. Because then you can use this. Yeah, this is the continuation of the previous technique. And you push here. Learn this kind of change. Then learn to pull them this way.
Okay, no movement, but what the thing is, Hasume-sensei never is fighting. Yeah, he's living, not fighting, just living. I think this is the most important thing for me in the technique. Okay?
Okay, hello.
Okay, so.
When he comes, it's important to drop down. When you're holding it here, drop down, drop your grip as well. And then already you're in a kamae. And then you just cut them. Just drop down. And then you're free. You can move it back.
Okay.
When he comes, you drop down. If you can't use one end of it, you use the other. But don't do what he's expecting either. So when you're using a long weapon, drop down so that you're free to move in whichever direction you want. Study this. The same with a stick or anything. Let's study more how the elbows are important. When he grabs you, just lift this up in Koppo Jutsu.
Okay.
If you can't lift it up, then you use the other hand.
Okay.
You've got to be able to move like this, with, like Pedro, without even looking. You can see what's coming. You're free to go and attack wherever you want. Centered around your elbow. Your elbow is the fulcrum. If he moves into the technique, you can respond this way. It's not fixed. If you think your belt's about to drop off, then use it as though it were dropping off. Since it's trying to teach the feeling here. There are some times when an enemy will attack you just when you're getting your pants down. But you've got to be able to respond well in that situation and change.
Okay.
That's where you've got kyojitsu, and that's where you've got a trap, too.
Okay. Fight it!
He tries to throw. It's important to move here, together with him. And then you're able to take him, take his thumb. You get a distancing. Quite simple.
Great.
Look at the movement when the person's trying to throw you. Everyone's trying to put in a lot of power when they're moving here. But if you put in any power at all, you're stopped, you're fixed. You won't be able to move to the next step. And sensei, like he's in Shizentai, he's free to do whatever he likes depending on what the opponent does. Because he's zero, he's at zero. Everybody is trying to do it too hard. Be more natural. Just be in Shizentai, and if he is throwing you, then go with it.
Thank you. Okay.
At this time. The reason you put your hands like this. You're safe if you've got this in there. It's a guard, you're protecting yourself. You can't reach. Yeah, you can actually, you can use your head against them. So that's another meaning of putting your hand in here, your elbow. Very simple things are actually the most important. Open him up. And take his weapon.
Okay.
Your hands have got to be free.
Okay.
And take his legs. Not trying to take the top half of his body.
Thank you.
Okay, let's go to the next technique. Moti, can you demonstrate?
Kamai から始めるんですね。
Sponge, I hit the
one. Poco no kamae, step in and answer. Very nice,
great. Hi, Nami-san.
Hi, ここで覚えますね。
Good. Done this. You avoid the first attack. Guard the other hand.
Okay.
When you move in here. And then knock downwards. With your whole body. The punch comes in.
Understand?
Okay, we're getting 10th stance to demonstrate. Bill Atkins first.
Okay, next break. Okay, once more. Okay, it's good.
When he punches, you've got to be able to move lightly, like this.
Okay.
You don't need to put on any technique. Just sort of guide them. You don't feel anything from sensei, any intention, no?
Yes.
It's very natural.
Okay.
Yes,
it's a trump. You look for his hit, and you think that he used his opponent for throw against you, and no throw, you step, and then change, and...
When he punches, it's important to learn to come to this side as well. It's important to waver like this. You just need to waver, to sway. It's important to move here and just take the leg at the bottom. You've got to have a totally different feeling for this movement. This is okay. This is okay too. You can employ any of the techniques we've been studying so far at this time.
はい、ポジション。 体で
use your body.
Case by case. You look, あの、研究してください。
You've got to study, it changes every time.
技から離れたコッポーで。
This is koppo, which is totally separate from individual techniques.
Okay.
はい、そうするとね、今の
So if you watch now, with the same technique, you can do it to the side here. They don't see what's happening.
Okay,
sorry. Oh, okay. It doesn't matter which side he's coming from.It's important to control them. It doesn't matter where they come from. The distance is important. This is important. The timing, you find you lose your timing, yeah?
Okay. やってる人のタイミング来るんだろ?
Yeah, the timing of the people who are trying to attack gets totally destroyed.
そういうコッポーを覚えるね。
That's the koppo that you need to understand, the feeling here.
どちらです
か? It doesn't matter which attacks.
考えないね。
Don't think about it.
取ろうとするからいけ。
Don't try and take it. And you're just in hokko no kamae. And then they overstretch themselves. They go over the top. And you're in hokko again. There's no need to hurry.
そういうコッポを覚えてください。
Learn this koppo of it, the art of it.
自然にコントロールしちゃうね。
Control them quite naturally.
技じゃないんだよな。
It's not a technique.
コッポね。
It's koppo, it's the art, it's the finer point of the art.
モテさん、今日のさっきやった技やってください。
Right, do the initial form of the technique as you showed it.
なんて名前だっけ?
What was the name of it again, Moti?
This technique is koyoko.
はい、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、OK、O So what's happening? You can stab into them.
Okay.
There are many ways you could hold a pistol, yeah? Sometimes maybe like this. And you just place it against him.
Okay.
Learn this way of doing it. As Sensei often says, there are many times when if you're using a gun, it's quicker to use it and just place it without pulling the trigger.
Than to.
than otherwise, because if you're just concentrating on pulling the trigger and shooting other people, you're not aware of other people trying to shoot you. If you're aware of the fact that the bullet might not come out of your gun, then you're also aware of the fact that you could be a target for somebody else.
Okay.
So here the space is very important. When he punches, it's like in Sanshin, you've got to be in a state where you're always ready to take it. Or it could be Bobi no Kamai. And then if he kicks, just go like this. You don't need to take your weapon. Or take them. It's okay to just stay here. So treasure this space. Use it. You've got to be able to use whatever weapon you can in that space. It's very important. It's worth learning well. Your intention should be just to sort of move over here. Move to this position. And don't try and apply any technique. Just sort of move with your body. You see his feet? What's happening there? If he tries to punch. So gradually we're just looking at the kokpo, the essence of the art. And that's why Sensei always says, don't learn the techniques, because he wants you to try and understand the essence and appreciate it. This kind of study is very important. You see what's happening? The feet. He had his heel. Okay, that's the end of the training for today. Let's do a continuation of what you were doing yesterday. This is Koppo Jutsu, so we're teaching the Koppo of it, the finer points.
Kakutogi no Koppo wo shite teru wake desu.
The Koppo of Kakutogi, martial arts in general.
Kyou wa waza nani kara hajimaru
desu kake na? So, what's the name of the first technique?
Shito.
Shito.
Shito. Shito ne.
Shito.
Hai. Shito. Shito no benkyou shimashou ne. Hai, play.
Shito.
Hai, yatte kudasai.
Okay, in this particular kata, the attack is grabbing, double lapel grab. Now what you want to be aware of, if you just go through the basic form, which is to guard against the hands and hit with this double koppo ken, obviously if the space is wrong, they're just going to bring their elbows up and stop that. And then you're open for a headbutt or a knee. So before you even think about the form of the kata, move, control the person, control the kukan. Okay, and that way they can't counter what you're going to do. And then you're driving this double koppo ken up to the temples, and then driving back down to the arm and peeling the hand off just with the shape of your wrist to make this single-handed gyaku. And then it's 50-50 power. 50% on the wrist, 50% on the koppo ken. You drive the attacker to the floor. Finishing them under control.
And one more, please.
Okay.
Technique called shito.
相手方両腕、締めに行く。
The opponent comes and tries to put on a shime, which is a choke with the both sides of the chest.
同時に、右手ボシカラ節、カスミアイシに当てます。
At the same time, use the boshi on the right hand to strike into kasumi. On the right hand.
左足を引いて。
Pull back left leg.
敵、そのまま、それで倒すわけですね。
And then knock them over.
はい、OK. バンドも振り。締めてきます。
She comes to put on the choke.
Okay,
play. Okay.
Okay, he comes with the choke. Don't forget this. He can't put on any choke now.Bring your arm to this position. Don't forget that. And then you move over here and strike.
All in the elbow again. Hey.
Just go like this.He won't be able to put on the choke. Don't forget to bring your hand here. Lift up. Learn the koppo of it. This is the important bit. Now you can take the other hand.
Thank you.
Each technique is not a sequence of moves, it's just a theme to work on.
コッポのテーマを記しているにすぎませんからね。
It's just indicating one theme for コッポ。
相手が来ました。
When he comes?
ここからこれ。
Move here.
こう持ってくるこれ。
And if you move it to this position, you're able to move into the strike. You're safe.
こっちに押す。こっちで押す。
And you're pushing with your right hand. You can't punch.
Understand? Help
me! Try and move this here as much as you can. You've got to be feeling it with your whole body. He can't put on the choke.Don't forget this and don't forget to keep walking.
Okay.
It's not a technique.It's kokpo. Wait a minute. This is important. Go with your body.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
This is a kamae, and another kamae, it's hokono kamae as well.
Okay.
It could be bobi no kamae. You understand? So you can do many different kamae here. The sensei said many times. You're not blocking him hard, you're just letting him move to a different position. You're doing this throughout. You're not testing your strength against them.
Okay.
Bring your hand to your shoulder. Hand to shoulder. The choke won't work. And then you can move around to strike to Kasumi. It's like your strength should be more elongated. Everybody's got it very solid in one place. It should be like throwing a ball. It should be very sort of long and stretched. And then you use your body to bring him down, lower his height. And you don't throw with the with just one hand. At the same time, you could be kicking them. And imagine you might have a weapon. So this is the koppo of the art. Everybody's already got good forms and techniques. So try and find and absorb the koppo for yourself. Forms, techniques and so on, humans can't really compete with machines anymore on that scale. But that's why you've got to learn the koppo, the feeling behind it, because that's human. That's the kind of thing that only humans could understand.
Okay.
This is okay too. Just with this, the choke won't work anymore. You probably didn't understand that there was a punch to Pedro's head in the middle of that, a strike to his head. If Sensei had done it for real, his neck would have been broken. Learn this koppo. Nothing should be fixed here. It's the koppo, the feeling.
Once more, please, speak in my
I felt free when he did el motoyaku, the joint, but suddenly, back, I felt my neck like that. I didn't understand what he's saying.
That's why you can't do techniques like this with people who aren't good at being an uke.
Uke
ga suru kara. Because they'd be seriously injured.
Ukemi mo jouzu natte kudasai.
So learn to get your ukemi good too.
Naeraita kara, boku ni waza yaraita kara tte minasan mo anshin shinai de kudasai. Boku wa warui otoko da kara. Korosu no ga suki da kara ne.
Don't relax just because it's sensei who's throwing you, because he's a bad boy, he likes killing people. Sorry, not killing, breaking. Like children.
Okay.
Like children breaking toys.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, let's look at the choke technique. Because in Japan, the kimono was the traditional way of dressing. Doesn't matter which side you grab. You can hold at the bottom too. You understand? You tuck it in there over your own hand. You can hold it at the top or at the bottom. And because this is cold, he feels that there's a knife against his neck. And he won't speak. He doesn't know what you're about to do.
Okay.
It's very important. So you've got to learn that everything changes depending upon what you're wearing. Since it's not grabbing the knife. You mustn't use this for any bad purposes. Since he's teaching this so that you know that some bad people might do this and you learn how to escape from it. There are people who might attack you like this. So that's why Sensei's teaching this, to teach you how to avoid such an attack. You don't know.
Are you? What? What?
Yeah.
I mean, the knife is going
through. You're using your elbow.
Boom.
That's why Sensei doesn't want to allow anybody into the Bujinkan as a member if they're not a good, correct person. These things are necessary so that you can protect people. They're very dangerous.
I pray!
It's important to go like this. Prince got better. He's not resisting so hard now. As he falls down, he's getting kicked.
Hi, Prince.
Okay, now the next way of doing a choke. This is one way of doing it. There's one here where you go onto both sides. Or going upwards. Or this way, or that way. You can do many things with your fingers to act as a choke.
Okay. それはもう本当。
Okay. 締めで聞かせようと思わないこと。
Don't try and make the choke work.
締めで持って相手の隙を見つける。
Use the choke so that you can find an opening in the opponent.
Same.
It's the same as with this.
Okay. 締めも強い人がいるからね。
Because there are many people who can resist a choke.
ね。締めてってもこれでゆっくりして頑張る人がいる。
You try and do it really hard and they're still very strong.
Okay. 固定観点は持たないね。
So don't have any fixed concepts about this.
反射的にっていうか、流れ的にっていうかな。最後のまで相手の戦闘力を奪うような動きにしていってくださいね。
You've got to be able to move in such a way that you respond or in a way flow with the opponent so that you can take away their ability to fight.
相手にこれで葉っぱ打ってくるよ。
Maybe, if you're doing this, then he'll try and strike your ears.
葉っぱ打ってくる。葉っぱ。
But if he does, try and... he won't be able to. So don't try and focus and concentrate too much on the actual choke itself. If he tries to go.
Okay.
And that's why Sensei, every time he doesn't teach just one technique, but three, four, or five, because it's too dangerous just to concentrate on one at any time. So try this for a bit. Just remember that the chokes are not only this one type. The hands could be the other way around, could be facing the other way. Everything changes there again.
Okay.
Like with this one too. It's not only a choke.
You can
hold the jaw, you can hold the eyes. Many different ways. Many ways of doing a choke. This is very good for a headbutt. When punching too, you should make sure that you don't injure your own fist. There are many occasions where if you just send your fist flying out, you actually hurt your own fist. So you've got to get the right distance for a punch.
Okay.
So you don't need to think about knocking them over. You've got to have a slightly wider perception of it as a martial artist. Don't be a martial artist sort of focused on one small point.
Okay. Hey, play!
So, right, with chokes, as before. You're doing a choke as before, but you use the other hand in a slightly different way. If you're doing it like this. Many different ways of doing chokes. So if he grows faint from the choke, and that's when you actually hit him. But don't have any fixed ideas. You don't need a lot of force for a choke. Because you can attack them again halfway through and then put on another choke. Don't practice this one.
Okay.
He puts on this. He puts on the choke, but it's important to move this way. Put your hand through. Control them. That's why this is being taught. You control them here. It doesn't matter if you can't get the sword with the first hand.
I thank you.
Many different techniques. Let's keep going then. He comes to put on a choke. He puts on the choke for real. Don't resist him, just move naturally. Move here and then you can break free. You control it with your neck so that it comes to just the right position for the stick to touch them. And that's why Sensei is moving his spine.
Okay.
Don't try and take him immediately. That's important. You can move around here.
Understand?
One more. You do this. You can break his arm with that.
Understand?
Do you understand? When he puts on the choke, move like that. And he thinks, what's about to happen? But don't put on any technique. You see? The important thing here is to move this way. Not just with the end of your hand. And both strike at the same time. It's very easy. Nothing very difficult here. If you just move like this, your hand and your head are both working at the same time.
Understand?
And your legs are important too.
Okay.
Just doing it with your hand is no good. It's got to be with your legs. Yeah. The hand and the head, everything is finding its way in.
Understood.
Nothing's fixed.